Meteorologist Dirk Verdoorn has more on if we might be able to actually see them here, Dirk.
If you live in the valley, your sky is not going to look like this. It's not going to be filled with stars. You're going to be filled with a low cloud cover. So if you want to see the Geminid meteor shower, you're going to want to get in the higher elevations. You want to get up above 1,500 to 2,000 feet, and that would be much better. And it's darker anyway, so that's a better place to view it. But this is going to be, again, tomorrow night into Sunday morning is when it peaks, the Geminid meteor shower. You want to be looking off towards the east, and the Geminid, the radiant, that's generally where these meteors are going to be coming from. So they can come in any direction, but kind of shooting from the east. And if you go after 9 o'clock, you will see the radiant. It's up there. It's not going to be the best viewing. The best viewing actually is going to be late in the night, not actually into Sunday morning, between 1 and 3 o'clock in the morning is going to be your best viewing. But you can still see some after 9 o'clock. So if you want to go out there, take a drive, get it to a higher elevation, sit back, and make sure you bundle up because it's going to be chilly. But you're looking at between, there's the Gemini constellation there, and also you have Jupiter that's going to be out there. That's another thing that you can look for. Look off to the east, and Jupiter's going to be coming up. Of course, that's going to continue to rise as we go through the night, but the find a dark location, and I've seen where, again, if under ideal circumstances, you could see up to 150 per hour, but again, those ideal circumstances are hard to come by.